Welcome back. You're watching Financial Planner. I'm in conversation with Certified Financial Planner Sumeet Ved, and we're talking about spending during the festivals. One of the things we touched upon was gold. And Sumeet, we were having this really animated discussion about what one should do with gold. And you feel that if you're going to buy any gold jewelry, ladies, make sure that you wear it. It could also serve as a great emergency fund because in case you need it, it's around and you can sell it and make some and get some easy cash. But talk to us about ETFs, and we were just about to get into that. A lot of people hear about ETFs, they don't know what it means or how they can get into gold using ETFs. Tell us about that.
Sure. To just reiterate what we were talking about, we said gold is an asset class, does have juice left in it, but for that, each and every fund house or financial planner will have its own philosophy, how much of that asset allocation should be.
Right.
And once you decide how much should you be allocating to gold, you can buy gold either in a physical format or through ETFs. That's where we were when we left for the break. So from an ETF point of view, it's a paper gold. What basically takes care of it is that you can buy exchange-traded fund, that's what ETF stats, for in form of gold, and there are a few asset management companies, in fact, quite a few of them right now, which are offering these products. Mm. And when you buy them, the beauty is you're not buying physical gold, though it tracks the same price.
Right. So it's, in a way, it's paper gold.
That's
and you need a DMAT account to do this, basically.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Then you have to, and I just want to run through a couple of pointers that I've written down about ETFs. So for someone who's just hearing the term right now and wants to know a little bit more, an ETF stands for an exchange-traded fund. You basically need a DMAT account. Give instructions to your broker to buy gold ETFs. The idea is to purchase small amounts of ETFs each month. You can accumulate them over a long term. What do you think about the limiting buying ETFs to 10% of your assets? Would that make sense? That would differ, right, from your financial goals perspective.
That's
depending
right.
on what your goals are.
That's right. It'll differ from goal to goal, and also differ from the philosophy of your financial planner.
Right.
Which will be discussed with you as a client of his.
What would you tell your clients then, if they want to invest in gold via ETFs?
So currently, Freedom as a house, financial planning house, is not recommending gold for goals which are less than 5 years.
Uh-huh.
We are recommending gold for 5 year plus, and our allocation is very tactical, ranges from 5 to 10%.
Okay.
But not more. The reason is we are just waiting for how rupee returns in gold will play out versus the dollar returns of gold itself. So it's slightly uncertain. That's what our allocation is as of now. Having said that, I'll also like to classify one more important point, and this is for viewers in large. Usually we have seen when there is a particular asset class which really runs up over a period of time and which gets talked about and which gets covered by a lot of the news channels, which gets talked about in social circuits, that's the time most of retail lay investors start buying that asset class.
Because it's a herd mentality too. You heard
right.
it, you heard, Mr. Khanna and Mrs. Khanna discuss how they got into gold ETFs, and you don't necessarily have all the knowledge, but you want to invest in it without understanding what it means.
That's right, and that becomes an emotional decision because you don't know how much of it you should be buying, when you should be buying, when you should be selling, which gold you should be buying it for. And most of the time we have seen, whatever asset class that might be, currently it's gold, later it might be equity, people usually end up burning their fingers in that, and then they become anti that asset class. Then you go to them and they say, no, I'll never buy gold. Why? Because, I bought gold once and really lost money.
So you should be prudent then when you make that choice, whether you want to invest in either gold or equities, then you should be thinking that thought through.
That's true. And when you say prudent, what it means is it needs to fit into your financial plan. It needs to fit into what goal are you trying to achieve by that particular asset allocation.
Right.
And that should not mean that all eggs are in one basket. It should have asset allocation which is diversified across and have a long-term perspective.
Okay.
Though it's boring, but it's very important.
Very important. And like you said, even if you want to get into gold, make sure that it's for a long term. And in Sumeet's case, in his mind, you must stay invested for at least a minimum of 5 years.
That's right.
What about gold gold ETFs then? How do you exchange it? Can you redeem your units? Talk us through what you can do with those ETFs once you have them.
As you mentioned, exchange traded funds are available in stock market, stock exchanges itself. So that what it means is whenever you want to come out of ETF, just go and sell that particular amount of units. Tell your broker, he'll go and sell that in market. Whatever that day's value is in the market itself, he'll draw it down. It'll come into your DMAT account and your bank account, and you can use the money out of your bank the way you want it to be. So just the way you buy any other scrip is how gold ETF also work.
Right.
Provided I'm again reiterating at the cost of sounding repetitive, it has to fit into a plan. It cannot be an impulsive, emotional, herd mentality decision to go and buy gold because everybody's talking gold, or it's a celebrity, celebration time, or it's a festival season, I'll buy gold.
Sure.
Wrong way to do it.
The wrong way to do it. Okay, it should fit your financial plan. Okay, I think we've come to pretty much the end of our discussion. So final word on gold jewelry. Any thoughts on that?
Please wear gold jewelry. It looks good. It's very interesting itself.
Right.
Don't go overboard in gold because everybody is talking about gold. Try and fit gold in part of your financial plan as an asset allocation. Once you have a financial plan and asset allocation, stick to it. And no emotional decision. Make it a rational decision.
Make it a rational decision. All right, Sumit, it was great to have you. Sumit Vaidya, certified financial planner over there, telling us a little bit on how to approach the entire festival season. Make sure you budget for your spending. And if you must buy gold, make sure, if you're buying gold jewelry, make sure you wear it. If you want to get into gold ETFs, make sure you understand it before you start investing. I have to wrap up the show. I want to thank you for watching. You can email us at financialplanner@utvmoney.com. Until next time, goodbye. And thanks, Amit.
Pleasure.